Hello everyone. In the last class we discussed first 7 questions in this exercise. And now let us start with the 8th one. A student multiplied 7236 by 65 instead of multiplying by 56. By how much was his answer greater than the correct answer? See, the teacher had given 7236 into 56. But the student made a mistake. Instead of 56, what did he write? 65. And now you have to find out what is the difference between 7236 into 65 and 7236 into 56. Now we will do this by drawing the lines like this. This is what is our first one. Students multiplication. Students, how did he multiply? Students multiplication. How much? 7236 into 65. Students multiplication, how did he do? 7236 into 65. So 5 6 are 30. 3, 5 3s are 15 plus 3, 18, 1. 5 2s are 10 plus 1, 11, 1. 5 7s are 35, 36. 6 6 are 36, you have to leave one blank. 6 6 are 36, 3 6 3s are 18 plus 3, 21. 2, 6 2s are 12, 14, 1. 6 7s are 42, 43. So your answer is 0. 8 plus 6, 14. 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 4 plus 6, 10, 1 plus 3, 4, 4 plus 3, 7, 4, 47,470,340. But what was the actual calculation? Actual calculation is, it had to be 7236 into 56. 6 6 are 36, 3 6 3s are 18 plus 3, 21, 2. 6 2s are 12, 14, 1. 6 7s are 42, 43. 5 6 are 13, 3. 5 3s are 15, 18, 1. 5 2s are 10, 11. 1, 5, 7s are 35, 36. So what is the answer? 6, 1, 8 plus 4, 12, 1 plus 1, 2 plus 3, 5, 6 plus 4, 10, 1 plus 3, 4. So what is the answer? 4,5,216. So what is the difference between the student's multiplication sum and actual calculation? What do you have to do? Find out the difference between the two. 4,70,340 minus 4,05,216. 10 minus 6, 4. 3 minus 1, 2. 3 minus 2, 1. 10 minus 5 is 5. 6 minus 0 is 6. So what is the difference between the actual and his multiplication by mistake? 65,124. Look at the 9th question. To stitch a shirt, 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. Out of 40 meter cloth, how many shirts can be stitched and how much cloth will remain? Now, understand the situation. For one shirt, you wear the shirts. How much cloth is needed? 2 meter, 15 centimeter. Whenever 2 meter, 15 centimeter units are different, you convert both into one. 2 meter also already into centimeter. Do you know how 1 meter is equal to how much? I said in the beginning of this chapter, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So 2 meter, 200 centimeter. 200 plus 15, 215 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ क्लॉथ इज नीडेड फॉर वन शर्ट. टोटली हाउ मेनी मीटर्स आर देयर? 40 मीटर्स. दैट मीन्स हाउ मेनी सेंटीमीटर्स? 14 to 100. 4000 सेंटीमीटर्स आर देयर. हाउ मेनी शर्ट्स कैन बी स्टिच्ड? सो हाउ मेनी राइट ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट्स फॉर दिस? यू राइट ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट वेरी क्लियरली. यू कैन राइट ऑफ what is it? Don't forget to draw the margin, statement column, value column, method column. What is the other one? Clock needed. Clock needed to stitch a shirt. A shirt. How much? 2 meters 15 centimeters. Here only you can write down 215 centimeters. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters, because 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. You know, so 2 meter 200 centimeters. 2 meter 15 centimeters 215 centimeters. Right. What is the next one? Therefore, number of shirts can be stitched from 40 meter cloth. What do you have to do? This one, whenever it is in centimeter, this one is also, you convert into centimeter. 40 into 100. How much? Whenever zeros are there, I say, count the number of zeros. 1, 2, 3. 4,000 centimeter. So what is your next verb? 4,000 divided by 215 plus 215 215s are 430 only 400 is there. So 1s are 215. What is the remainder? 10 minus 5 is 5. 9 minus 1 is 8. 10 minus 5 is 5. 9 is remaining. 9 minus 1 is 8. 3 is remaining. 3 minus 2, 1. 1,850. Right? So again, I'm sure 8 times, 9 times it is not possible. Let us try with 8 times. 8 5s are 14. 4. 8 1s are 8 plus 4, 12. 1. 8 2s are 16 plus 1. 17. So 0, 3, 1. So number of shirts can be stitched from the 40 meter cloth is 18 shirts. How much? 18 shirts. Now what is the next question? How much cloth is remaining? 130 centimeter or length of the cloth remaining. Length of the cloth remaining is equal to how much? 130 centimeter or 1 meter 30 centimeter. This is your answer. 18 shirts, 1 meter 30 centimeter. Need to understand. So, 1 shirt 215 centimeter, then you everything convert into centimeter and then you divide. You will get the correct answer. 10th question. Medicine is packed in boxes, each weighing 4 kg 500 gram. How many such boxes can be loaded in a van which cannot carry beyond 800 kg? Try to understand. In one box, 4 kg 500 gram or 4.5 kg of medicine is there. that lorry or that vehicle can withstand only 800 kg. So how many such boxes can be loaded? That is the question they were asked. So what you do? One box, weigh of one box, 4.5 kg or 4 kg 500 gram. 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. You all know. So how many boxes can be filled in a vehicle which cannot carry more than 800 kg? So what I do? 800 divided by 4.5 kg. Right? So for our simplicity, we'll convert everything in gram. Then it is easier for us. What is the statement we can write? See, medicine is packed in a box, each weighing. So, weight of a medicine box. 10th question. Weight of a medicine box. How much? 4 kg, 500 gram. Or 4500 gram. Therefore, number of medicine boxes, can be filled in a van which cannot carry 800 kg. What do you have to do? You do 800 kg divided by 4 kg 500. So now it's your work to convert everything in grams. 800, 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. So 800 into 1000. How much you get? 800 into 1000 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 8 ones are each. So I do 8,000. See, 8. 8 lakh, 8 lakh divided by 4,500. See, for the division, work to be become simpler, whatever extra zeros are there will cancel. If you please don't strike off like this, there is a not the spirit of mathematicians to do like that. In two zeros are extra here. Two zeros I can strike off like that. Please don't do that. If you were doing, stop it. What is that number having two zeros? 100. So you can say 145 are 100. Now we are doing the same thing, but we are striking off the full number. Two zeros less. 1, 2, 3. Right? Now we'll do 8000 divided by 45. 45 twos are 95. 90. 45 ones are 45. Right? I will rub this and from there I will do 8000 divided by 45 so that it is very much clearly seen to you. 8000 divided by 45. 45 ones are 45. 45 twos are 90. That is why only 8 is there. 10 minus 5 is 5. 7 minus 4 is 3. 35. 350. I think 4 8s are. Let us try with 8. 8 5s are 44. 8 4s are 32 plus 4. 36. 8 is not possible. Only 7. 7 5s are 35. 3 7 4s are 28 plus 3, 31. So 10 minus 5 is 5, 4 minus 1 is 3. Again 3, 15. 45 sevens are 315. Again 35. So how many boxes? Only 177 boxes can be filled. So 177 boxes. So weight of the lorry will be not more than 800 kg. Weight in the lorry, right? Yes. 11th question. The distance between the school and a student's house is 1 kilometer, 875 meter. You know 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter, right? Every day she walks both the ways. 1 kilometer, 875 meter to go. 1 kilometer, 875 meter to come back. If she walks all the 6 days in a week, how much distance she walks? So what do you have to do? How much she walks in a day, you find out. 8 to 6 you do. That's all. Right? So what shall we do? We'll start the statement. Yes. So how may we write down the distance between the school and a student's house? The distance between school and student's house. How much? 1 kilometer, 875 meter. Therefore, distance she walks in a day. As she goes to the school, she has to come back. So it is enough, it is understood very much. Distance she walks in a day. How much? 1 kilometer means 1 kilometer is how much? 1000 meter. 1000 plus 875. So 1875 meter to go, 1875 meter to come back. Or 1875 into 2, let us say. 1000 you can add or you can multiply by 2. 2 5s are 10. 1 2 7s are 14 plus 1 15. 1 2 8s are 16 plus 1 17. 1 3715 meter she walks a day. Therefore, distance she walks in 6 days. 6 days. What do you do? In 1 day, so many meter. In 6 days, how much? 3750 into 6. 6 zeros are 0. 6 fives are 33. 6 7s are 42 plus 3, 45, 4. 6 3s are 18 plus 4, 22. So 22,500 meter. Or again you can write down 22,000 means 22 kilometer. 22 kilometer, 500 meter. Like that also you can write down. Or 22,500. Right? Because 22,000 means 22 kilometer. 22,500 meter means 22 kilometer, 500 meter. So much she walks in a week or in 6 days. The last question of this exercise and today's class. A vessel has 4 liters 500 ml of curds. In how many glasses each of 25 ml capacity can be filled. There is one big vessel in that 4 liters 100 milliliter means 4.5 liters of curd. And that should be distributed to glasses of small size of 25 ml. How many glasses can be filled? What do you do? Big number divided by small number. So how do you proceed? What is that? A vessel has 4 liters 100 ml of curd. Quantity of curds or capacity, quantity of curds already. Quantity of curds in a vessel. How much? 4 liter 500 milliliter. Then capacity of a glass. How much? 25 ml. Therefore, number of glasses can be filled. So which is the bigger number? Everything will convert into milliliters. 4 liter is 4000 plus 500. 4500 divided by 25. You understood? 4 liter is 4000 milliliter. 4000 plus 500. 4500 milliliter divided by 25. 25 ones are 25. 45 minus 25 is 20. Take another 0. 25 8s are 200. So 200 minus 200 is 0. This 0 is remaining. So put it here. So 25 zeros are 0. So how many glasses can be filled? 180 glasses can be filled with the curds. What is the capacity? 25 ml capacity of each glass. Total how much quantity of curds is there? 4.5 liters or 4500 milliliters. So I hope you understood all these sums very clearly. If you like my video, please share it with others and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.